race fans, and welcome to the Bnl Raceway, where today's race of the Tripledent 310 is held today. We got a lot of fast engines today. I'm Bob Cutters with my good friend Daryl Carter, and today we are going to see the new next gen, the racers of our future, take on this new renovated track that's been made up to their standards. And Bob, you are right about that. This race should be an exciting one. These next gens usually calculate at a speed of 210. 210, that's ridiculous. But you know what else is ridiculous? The fact that Lightning McQueen is even on this track. No disrespect on his name, that is. No disrespect to Lightning's name, but the fact that he is out there is kind of ridiculous. These next gens should be able to pass him with ease. But hey, he's Lightning, and he's been known for unexpected victories. And so, we'll see what happens here today. It's just going to be a fun race. And it seems like the racers are ready for their pace lap. As they are ready for their pace lap, let's see who's going to be on pole. We have Jackson Storm and Daniel Suarez on row 1. Row 2 has H.J. Hollis and Ryan Insight-Laney. Ryan Insight-Laney sure is a good next gen. And now, row 3, we have Cam Spinner and Harvey Rodkep, two new cars. And then, row 4, Chris Roman, along with fan favorite Cruz Ramirez. Let's hope she can move up soon. Row 5, Herb Kerbler and Bubba Wheelhouse Jr. And then, row 6, Chase Race-A-Lot and Tim Tretlers. Row 7 has Sheldon Shifter and Conrad Camber. And row 8 has Dan Carcina, Spikey Phillips. And the next row has Paul Conrad and Eric Breaker. I believe this is actually their first time on the track. And then row 10 has Ed Trunkin and Lightning McQueen. He's all the way in the back. Just shows he didn't do good on qualifying. And row 11 rounds out Rich Mixon. Here's the race info. 10 laps around this 2-mile tech circuit. 21 cars present on the track. And Jackson Storm is in the lead. And now let's go. Pretty fast start for Storm. That's Daryl. Seems like Jackson Storm is already having an early lead, but it shows. But the other racer, Lightning McQueen, just moved through the field a little. Jackson Storm with a very early lead. I can't believe lap one is already over. Storm with a very early lead. Cruz Ramirez is moving slightly through the field. And oh, there's a lot of cars bashing into each other. And Lightning McQueen even jumps the barrier to avoid the crash. This is very unfortunate, Daryl. This ended a lot of cars today. Here's the cars that were actually involved. Ryan Insight-Laney, Chris Roman. Those were a lot of good cars. Let's look at the instant replay. So it shows that Ryan Insight-Laney and Cam Spinner were right next to each other. But it looks like Ryan Insight-Laney tried to get over. But then Cam Spinner was right there and it just caused this whole wreck. Chris Roman even flipped on his side. Good move by Lightning McQueen on his part, avoiding the crash and being able to move to the field slightly because of that. Daggum. Good thing there was three cars around you. Still get away from that. And the cars have been stopped with the yellow flag during the back straightaway. It looks like the cleanup crew is actually came. Cruz Ramirez, Tim Travis, and Chase Race-A-Lot are still in this race. So I hope they have to go into pit to get some tires on. And the cleanup crew is cleaning up the cars. And we have word that the cars are ready to pit. Pretty fast pit stops from those teams. It looks like the callers are being regrouped, doing their pace laps. While they're doing their pace laps, let's cut to commercial break.
Afraid to go for a drive because of a leaky tailpipe?
What?
I'm Lightning McQueen for leak less. Hit the trail without leaking on the track.
That was only supposed to air overseas.
Welcome back with the updated race info, where we start on lap 5 out of 10. 14 cars left in the race. Storm still in first, and Lightning McQueen has moved up to 10th. Now let's see who takes this home. Oh boy, Storm was a very early lead, but it looks like Lightning McQueen and Cruz Ramirez is moving through the field pretty fast. On lap 6, Lightning McQueen and Cruz has advanced through the field already. That's right, Gerald. It looks like these two racers have finally gotten their mojo, and and they're moving through the field pretty fast. Lap 7, Lighting McQueen cruising there as an advance to the top 5. Contact between Ed Trunkin and Tim Trellis, however. Cruz is on Storm's tail, and Lighting McQueen has jumped his way to 3rd. It's gonna be a 3-way battle for the lead, too. And it looks like, oh, Tim Trellis blows a tire and causes a small wreck. On the instant replay, the yellow flag, he collects Eric Breaker and Rich Mixon. The caution is out. Very unfortunate for Tim Trellis and Eric Breaker, who have both avoided the crash today, very slightly. They were involved. It looks like Tim Trellis did blow a tire, making a bad move, not going into the pits. 36, Rich Mixon took some front damage, but will be able to continue the race. Isn't that fortunate? The cleanup crew, the tow trucks, they finally came and decided to pick up these two. And it seems like Rich Mixon is out of pit lane. And we are going to be restarting on the final lap. Never before. This is going to be a sprint to the finish. Let's see who takes it home. My money's on McQueen. Whoa, Daryl, we just have to see if McQueen's able to pull a move. And we're back to green, lap 10, final lap. Lighting McQueen did jump into second, though, and he's on the inside of Storm. The racer's flying by. Lighting McQueen, Storm, it's Cruz Ramirez. I don't believe it. Boy, I wasn't even paying the attention to Cruz back there. Let's look at the instant replay, Bob. Cruz Ramirez pulls a wall maneuver to pass Storm and Lightning at the last second. Simply amazing, Bob. That was one sure heck of a win on Cruz Ramirez's part. And she is on the podium, celebrating her win at the Bnl Speedway. She did come first, and Storm did come second. He just looks plain frustrated, Bob. In third place, Lightning McQueen, very surprising. And H.J. Hollis in fourth. Daniel Suarez is upset about his fifth place finish when he should have had fourth, and Dan Garcia in sixth. Seventh, Spikey Phillips, and eighth, Paul Conrev, and ninth, Ed Trunkin, and tenth place, Conrad Camber of Shiny Wax. And the last two, 11th, Chase Race-A-Lot, and 12th, Rich Mixon. Here's all the racers that did not finish the race, and it's a lot of them. So if your favorite racer was on here, I'm very sorry on that, but they should have done a better job, honestly. Oh boy, what a heck of a race. Well, that concludes our adventure at the Bnl Raceway today. On behalf of Bob Cutlass and me, Daryl Cartrip, have a great day, and we'll see you all next time.